Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, we're going to look at the what and more importantly, the why of the XMLA endpoint with Power BI. Stay tuned. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. XMLA endpoint is interesting because it allows you to do so many things with Power BI. This actually came up as a question on one of our recent live streams from Matthias, who's a regular viewer and attendee of those live streams. And he asked a question, what's the point of the XMLA endpoint? He was actually trying to make a joke during the stream, which was fun, but it actually made me think about, we've talked about the XMLA endpoint, but we've never really looked at what it was really about. In this video, I want to do just that. But also real quick, if you're not joining our live streams, we do it every Saturday morning at 9:30 a.m. Central Time here on the Guy in a Cube channel. Come hang out. We've got a lot of folks from the product team that tend to join, as well as just a lot of great folks from the community asking questions, answering in the chat, all sorts of great fun. Be sure to join us for that. All right, enough of all this talking. You know how we like to do it on Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. All right, when we're talking about the XMLA endpoint, first and foremost, this is a premium only feature. So you have to have either a Power BI premium capacity or premium per user. In this case, I'm actually using premium per user. You can see that by way of the diamond up by the workspace name. When you have the workspace set up, if we go to settings and we go to the premium tab, whether it's premium per user or premium per capacity, you will see this workspace connection. This is the XMLA endpoint. That's the magic right there. This is effectively a connection string. This is what we can use when we work with tools, when we work with other items that we want to connect to the premium workspace or the data set from outside of Power BI. So if you remember back in the old days, we used to supply server name and database name. Well, this is the server name. And so if you have a tool that can connect to analysis services, you can use the XMLA endpoint to connect to Power BI Premium. So now effectively your premium capacity or premium per user is an analysis services server. So that means we can do all sorts of great things. So let me just copy this. There are older tools such as the SQL Server management tools. These were used back with analysis services. If you're familiar with SQL Server, you've probably used these. And again, I mentioned this is just a connection string. We're going to put that in the server name box. And in this case, because it's Power BI Premium or Premium per user, I'm going to connect with my tenant connection. So I want to use Azure Active Directory. In this case, I just choose Universal with MFA. The other thing to note is you should specify the actual data set name. So in this case, I'm connecting to database, which is the data set. In this case, it's AdventureWorks. And how do I know that? Because if I go back, there's my data set and it's AdventureWorks. Easy peasy. So if we come back, I can hit connect. And I'm gonna have to log in. Once we're in, then we can see those data sets, right? So I see AdventureWorks, I have connections, I have tables. I can do all sorts of crazy things, right? I can make adjustments. In this case, I could do something what Patrick talked about in his video about refreshing a single table. Spoilers, this is gonna kind of give that video away. All right, so I can come down to process table and I can say I wanna process default on my internet sales table. And let's just say script it. And when I script it, this is effectively an XMLA command and I can run this against the XMLA endpoint. So at this point, regardless of how I'm trying to issue this statement, this is going to work because it's going against the XMLA endpoint. This is true for analysis services. It's true for Azure analysis services and it's true for Power BI Premium. So let me go and execute that. It executes the query, and then at some point it will be done, and bam, we just refresh the individual table without doing anything else. This gives me all sorts of capabilities from an administrator perspective, from a developer perspective. I can do all of these things with the XMLA endpoint. That's great. When it comes to refresh specifically, let me show you something else. So if we go look at the refresh settings and we go to refresh history, it'll show you if it's on demand through the UI, it'll show you if it's a scheduled refresh through the UI or through Power BI itself, or in this case, it was refreshed through the XMLA endpoint and it will show you that in the refresh history so that you can track that. From a tracing perspective, we can use the XMLA endpoint to do that as well with something called SQL Profiler Trace, which is part of when you install Management Studio tools. This is an old tool that's been around for a long time and used with the on-premises technologies as well as things like Azure Analysis Services. Let's take a look at that. I actually had it running in the background. You do the same thing, right? We're going to connect to it. And then when I've scheduled, I pick the events that I want to do. And when those events occur, it'll be traced with inside of a given item. So here we've got Management Studio's tracing. So let's actually have some fun here. Let me open up DAX Studio. Again, I'm going to connect to that XMLA endpoint. Let's specify the catalog. I'm going to connect to that. I'm going to choose my user. And then I'm just going to issue a query, right? So this is a query from a visual and a report. I'm just going to run this query, or I could even clear cache and run. Be very careful about clearing cache on the XMLA endpoint. If this is a production data set, you're affecting the production data set, right? And clearing that cache. So it could result in your end users. Oh, wow. This got really sluggish for a second because it's trying to rewarm that cache. So just be aware of that. So we ran it. We got results. If we go back to our SQL Server profiler trace, and there we go. It took a couple seconds for it to show up, but we can actually see if I go to this query begin, that's the actual query that we executed inside of DAX Studio that is now being traced. So we executed it against the XMLA endpoint, and then we're also tracing it from the XMLA endpoint as well. So we can do these things to monitor items that are on the actual service itself to get that information. So we looked at the different tools that we can use against XMLA endpoints, like SQL Server Management Studio, SQL Profiler, DAX Studio. You can also use Tabular Editor as well, and you can actually make adjustments to the model and deploy those directly against the XMLA endpoint if you're in an enterprise deployment type scenario. This also leads into other questions about source control. Can we get into like change deployment, CI/CD type scenarios? And you can absolutely do that from a model perspective. I did a video on actual source control options, and I talked about the XMLA endpoint as an option there for the model specifically. So you can take full advantage of that from a code perspective, also from applications. So things like DAX Studio, that code is writing against something like ADOMD, which is a client library that you can actually communicate with the actual analysis services endpoints at that point. Those are all options that are available for you when you're working with the XMLA endpoint. One last thing I want to call out from a setting perspective, you can actually configure how you can interact with that XMLA endpoint. Let me show you that real quick. If we go to the admin portal, in this case, this is using premium per user, and premium per user will have a setting for the XMLA endpoint, which is down here. So you can determine whether the endpoint is off altogether, if it's read-only, or if you can read right. So for read only, you can do things like tracing, you can do query statistics, things of that nature. You can also, you know, get catalog type information. For read write, that would be if you wanted to actually publish model changes. If we actually jump over, premium capacity is the same thing. So if I'm actually on a premium Gen 2 instance, this is a P1, and I come down to workloads under data sets, you'll see that same option there for the XMLA endpoint. And then from a tenant settings perspective, if we go to the admin portal and go to tenant settings, there's also an XMLA as well. So there's a setting here of whether or not you actually want to even allow it or which security groups that you're going to enable for that. So you can actually control who has access to it, who can use it, just from a governance perspective, which is always nice. All right, I want to hand this over to you. What do you think? Are you using the XMLA endpoint? Are you not using it? And I just made you aware that this even exists. Let me know in the comments below what you think. I'd love to hear it. Let's continue the conversation there. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button, smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.